Good morning, students. So, ready for the computer class? Children, in the previous class, you have learned about the basic formatting tags used for designing a web page, like the body tag, the p tag, the font tag, and we have also done the attributes related to the body tag. Most of the tags, they can take one or more attributes, which we would be doing in details as we proceed ahead. So now we know the body tag and the font tag in details. In this class, we would be learning about how to insert images and how to use lists in a web page. Now children, let's see. The page that I have decided for today's class is this kind of a page. Let's have a look. Now we will be creating this kind of a page, which is a vision board. A vision board is basically a board which is used to display your visions. Say for example, in holidays, you feel bored at times or you feel demotivated. So you can make up a board in which you put up different pictures of what you want to do, what you want to become. It's basically a life journal that these are your aims, these are your likes, these are your dislikes. So this picture basically tells us about the steps how to create a vision board. Right. So let's start creating the page. As we all know, the page has to be created in Notepad. So we would be creating a page in Notepad. Now in the Notepad, children, I've already created the head section with HTML head title. I have given the title here as creating a vision board. And I've closed the head section. Now I move on to the body section. In the body section, we needed to give a heading first. So I'm giving the H1 tag, that is there for the heading. And then the rest of the thing was written in the next line. I simply move on to how to create a. And then I have to take it to the next line. So I will here close my H1 tag. And I'll give a break tag. And next I need to write in another H1. Alright, now this was also in the center, so I need to give a center tag here. I will close my center tag after the heading slash center. Now we also know that we have to create a different font style for how to create and then a vision board. So what I am going to do is I'm going to give here a font tag. Now to give here the font tag, I'll write here font. And if I need to change the style of font, I use the attribute font face. Close the double quotes. You want to increase the size. The size can also be increased. It is only from 1 to 7. I can give it a color also. COLOR. The color here I take as blue color. Alright, so this is how my font is going to look. Now, vision board is in a different font. So what I need to do is, before I take a break, I am going to close the font tag. See, so this is entirely for the first line, H1, font face, color, then how to create a, and H1 closes, and H1 has not yet closed, I'll close it, and then the font is also closing. So this is only for the first line. Now similarly, we need to do it for the second line also. So now for doing it for the second line, again what I'll do is, I'll take the font face. Now instead of taking the font face as Berlin Sans, I'll choose another one. Here also I can change the color. I take the color as green. You can choose the colors on your own. In my previous videos, I've also given the color code. Instead of writing the name of the color, if you want a particular shade, you can choose the shades available from that video. The shades are given at the end. They're all hexadecimal shade codes that can also be used in place of color is equal to, just type in that shade code. Now I have done this. Now I again need to close the font tag. All right, now let me save my work. Now children, while we are saving our work with the file extension .html, at times we make a mistake also. Right now, see, I'm going to save it on the desktop and show you. When I save my work as a name .html, I click on save. Now let me minimize this. Let me minimize this. See, I have saved it with visionboard.html. Whenever I'm saving it with .html extension, it should come like a web browser icon. It should have a web browser icon to it. If it is not having a web browser icon, means you have made a mistake while saving it. You need to save it again. If it is showing you the text pad kind of an icon, it means there is a mistake. Alright, now let me open my page. See, this is how to create vision board. I can see vision board is looking a little smaller in size. So, of course, I'm going to give a size over here. There are only 1 to 7 sizes available. That's it. That is all I need to do. Nothing else. I'll save it. And let me increase, refresh it from here. It has made it of big color. So we have got how to create a vision board. Now next, let us move on to the next part of it. Now the next part was we had to use these bullets. These are actually bullets. These are all written in bullets. So we will now be learning how to insert bullets into our web page. So these are known as lists in HTML. You can have ordered list as well as unordered list. Ordered list means where you have 1, 2, 3 or ABC or Roman 1, 2, 3 written. So these are all ordered list. Now here there is no ordering. It is just bullets which are coming. So this kind of list is known as an unordered list. To create an unordered list, go to HTML. In HTML, to create an unordered list, we use the UL tag. UL means U for unordered and L for list. This tells the system that we are using an unordered list. So now for an unordered list, you can have different types of bullets. It gives you bullets only. There is no ordering in an unordered list naturally. We can have different types of bullets here. So let's do first the simple one. The list starts with the UL tag. Now in the UL tag, to tell the system that yes, here this is the place where you have to give the bullet, we make use of the tag LI. HTML is not case sensitive, so I'm going to write here LI. LI stands for list item. That means here we will have the first list item. First bullet will come here. Now this whole was to come as first bullet. Now here the first bullet ends, so here I'm going to end my LI tag. So this means first bullet is over. Now for the second bullet, again I'll have LI. LI is the list item. UL tells us that the unordered list has started. LI tells that these are the places you have to put the bullets. Now for the next list item, we have here the second list item ends. Now finally we have the third list item. The third list item is here we end the list item. Now once we have put all the list items in the list, what we need to do is we need to close our UL tag. That means here my unordered list, they close. Now if we want, we can give a font style to the list items. So how do we give a font style? Here before beginning the UL, we can specify font face is equal to choose a font face. But before choosing, what we'll do is we'll see currently we are using Arial. So after choosing the font face, we are going to set it back to Arial, and here I'll set the color also. So this font I have chosen for my list, and once the list is over, I am going to close the font tag. Then I close my body tag. Then I finally close the HTML tag. Right now I save my work. I have done it with Control S and I click on the refresh icon. Now you can see the entire list has come here. Whatever we had typed, though it is a little smaller in size, so we can of course increase the font size, we can give more spacing in between, but you have got bullets, right? Now this board is looking a bit white in the background. If we want, we can give a BG color to it. BG color means background color. Or if we want, we can give an image also. Alright, so I have inserted a background image. I'll just do Control S, check my file, and you can see my file has got the background image. Now this is my vision board. Till now I have put a heading and I have written it, written all the steps also. I have put bullets also. Now what I need to see. Now I need to put, if I see my picture here, there is a picture over here kept. So before starting to create your web page, always keep your pictures ready. Like I had downloaded my background image, I have also downloaded the picture that suits me. Not necessarily you get the same pictures, whatever picture you get, you can insert. For a background, you need to check the dimensions. Otherwise, for inserting a normal image, there's no need to check the dimension. You can have a small image also on the web page. All right, so now let's learn how to insert an image on the web page. So what I'm going to do is I'll open my web page. Now here I need to insert an image. For inserting an image, I will be using the IMG tag. IMG tag is a tag that we use for inserting images. Now along with the IMG tag, I would be using the SRC attribute. SRC attribute, this is used to specify the URL or the path of the image to be displayed. Right now my file as well as my image, they are in the same folder. So I will not be specifying the path. In case they are in separate places, you need to specify the path. And how do you get the path? Suppose this is your picture, right click on it, go to properties, and you can get the name of the picture from here. Now otherwise, when you right click on the picture, you get this path. This, the location here, this is the complete path of the picture. You can directly copy it and paste it in your file, in your notepad file. But if you have your picture and the HTML file in the same folder, you just need to copy the name of the image. So here the name, I'm just going to copy it, put double quotes. This is exactly the name of the image. With the image comes the attributes. First attribute is the SRC. Now with the image, you can also have a border attribute. Now this border attribute, it specifies the width of the border around the image. You can again have it from 1 to 7, 7 being the highest. So just write border is equal to the thickness of the border that we want. The color of the border would be according to the font color that we have chosen till here. If there is no font color chosen, it will be black in color. Then you can also have the alt attribute. Alt attribute is the attribute that specifies the alternate text that the browser will display if the image is not displayed. By any chance, if the path is wrong or your image has got deleted, if the image is not getting displayed, then this alt attribute will display the text, whatever you have written. I'll just show you this also. Then you also have the height and the width attribute that are used to change the height and the width of the image. That also we'll be seeing. I'm just going to close the angle bracket. Now children, I had told that whenever a tag contains some text, it is applicable on some portion of the text, it is called a container tag. But you can see the image tag does not contain any text. It is used for displaying images only. So it is an empty tag. It is not a container tag because it is not applicable that from here to here, this would be the picture. This is only for displaying a picture. So it is a empty tag. You do not have to close it. Now let us see, is our picture visible? So I save my work here and I open the page. You can see the picture here with the black border because we had already closed the font tag beforehand. See here, when I open my picture, open with notepad. All right, this is the document here, and when I see this document, see here, the font phase had started here, the color was there, the size was there, and we had closed the font. Now, if I do not close the font over here, I take the font and close it over here. Then let's see, does it make a difference? Now the border has become blue in color. So the border of the picture depends on the border of the font color that you have already chosen. Now apart from this, this picture can change the size. This we are going to discuss. This picture can also change its alignment. Right now this picture is on the left because by default the alignment is left. The images can have different types of alignment. That is, you can use align it to the left or we can align it to the right. Now along with these alignment options, we also have the height and the width attribute of the image. That is, we can make the image smaller as well as larger. For changing the height and the width, you again need to know the size of the image. So let's come back to our image. The image is saved here. We go to the properties, and in the properties, in the details, we see the height and the width, 785 and 440. So naturally we can make it smaller. First is the width. Width is 785 and the height is 440. So here in my image tag, I'm going to reduce the height and the width. I take the height as, here it is 440. Okay, I make this height as 300, and then I can choose the width also. I can use this these two attributes, height and width, along with the alignment attribute. There is no problem. All the attributes of a particular tag can be used together. Now let us see. I am going to save this work, and let me see, has my picture reduced in size? Let's see, the picture has got reduced in size. So these are all the attributes of the image tag. In the image tag, we have done the SRC attribute to give the source to the image. Then the height width attribute to give height and width, to change the height and width of the image. Usually the images cannot increase in size. Not all the images can increase. Few can, but decrease they all can. So you can decrease the size of the image and see. Then you can align your image. You can align it according to the margins, that is left alignment or right alignment, or you can align them with respect to the text, top, middle or bottom. Then you have the alt attribute. Okay, we have not discussed the alt attribute. We have discussed the border attribute. The border attribute is used to give a border to the image. Now let us see what happens in case the image is not displayed at all. Now let us see what happens where the image is not displayed. Now suppose I go to my code. Alright, I'll close this also. Children, remember to keep on closing your files. Otherwise there'll be a lot of confusion. When you create so many files on the taskbar, you will not know to make changes on which file. So close all the files, open with notepad, and here. Now by mistake, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the spelling of this image. In place of two S, I just make it a single S. Now it does happen at times that the spelling becomes wrong while typing the spelling. So what happens in this case? Now we do not have any image with this particular name. I click on Control S, close this. Now I go to the image. Now I cannot see the image at all, but I can see whatever I had written in my alt attribute. So this attribute is displayed only when the image cannot be displayed. All right, now so this makes us clear with how to create a vision board, how to use the list items here. Now while using the list, this time we have used the unordered list. Now children, in unordered list, what we can do is, I have told you there are three types of bullets which the system provides us. Now let us see, where is our unordered list coming? The unordered list is starting from here. Now this, the normal, when we do not type anything, we get circular bullets. But if we want, we can have other type of bullets also. So we start the unordered, we define the unordered list with UL, and in UL we define the type attribute. Now when we do not define any type, it by default takes it to be disk type. Now I'm going to define a type, say I take it to be circle. A disk is a filled circle. Now I am giving the type circle. Type is the attribute of UL and circle is its value. Once I've given this, I'm going to save my work and I'll see how it comes. Is there any change or not? See, of course there's a change. You can see these are empty circles over here. So the bullets have changed. With disk, D-I-S-C, They were filled circles, which is the default type. Now when I give circle, it comes empty circles. Now I can also use a third type, that is square. I can have a square bullet also. I save it and I refresh. You see, these are all now square bullets, square filled bullets. So UL has got three types. One is your square bullets, the other is the circle, that is empty circles. The third one is the disc, D-I-S-C, which gives you the filled circles, which is the default one also. Now, in place of UL, that is unordered list. If you want to create an ordered list, that is also very simple. Now, you just have to tell the system it is an ordered list. So, in place of UL, ordered, since it starts from O, so I'm going to make use of O. Ordered list, O for ordered, L for list. Now the type will definitely change. For the ordered list, you have the type as A. I'll just show you quickly the different types with ordered list. First, let me do it without any type. I am not using any attribute. The default is the numbers. And I'll close here the OL attribute. I'll save it and I'll see the changes here. You can see 1, 2, 3 has come in place of bullets. So this is the ordered list, with the default ordered list without specifying any type. Now in the type here, instead of writing this circle or square, we have the type as, I'm quickly showing you all the types. You can have a small a, which shows small a, b, c, d. You can have a capital A also. It will start showing you capital A, B, C, D. You can have, I'll show you here all together. Either you can have a small a, or you can have a capital A, or you can have I, that is for Roman numbers, or you can have small I again, that is for Roman numbers in small letters. These are all values which the type attribute can take. Right now I will do it for A. You can choose any one of them, but only one at a time. And apart from choosing the type here, you can also choose the start value. Start value means if I say start from 1, so it will start from A, B, C. If I say start from 2, it will start from B. Okay, let's see. By default it is starting from 1 only. I just save this and I refresh my page. See, I get ABC. It starts from A only. Now I want my list to start from B. So I'll make the type as A only and I'll write here start, which is another attribute which tells the list its starting position. I say start from, say, 2 or start from 3. Any number. 3 in ABCD means C. So let's see, does it start from C? See, the list starts from C. So here in ordered list, you can have, in addition to the type attribute, you can have the start attribute also, which defines the starting value of a list. So children, this week you are going to practice how to create a vision board. Do attempt the quiz which is given in the form. Thank you.